Ivan Cheltsov's second book in his new books.
Thank you very much. So let me remind that yesterday we classified the bad smooth Delpeza surfaces and smooth two-dimensional fun varieties, and we in particular proved they bounded. Let me remind that this is was suppose that this is smooth Fana of dimension 2, which basically means anti-canonical divisor is ample, and this means square of this divisor is positive, and intersection with every curve positive. Okay, and if I assume it's smooth, then this property is preserved when you contract minus one curves. And then you get some minimal surface, you can say, and such that there's no minus one curve. And then you have two choices. Either this is P2 or P1 cross P1. Yeah, and this basically gives you the classification. Classification, this is a special case. And you can always assume this is P2. Yeah, in particular, you have this boundness. And this is blow up of at most 8 points in general position. And the reason that canonical square of canonical divisor of P2 is 9. And each time you blow up, square of canonical divisor drops. Okay.
Поменяй карандаши.
Yes, yes, yes. So, one can ask, this approach, of course, is very special. It's really, really used properties of everything here. Like it's smooth contraction of minus one curves, then classification of minimal Delpeza surfaces without minus one curves. It's very, very rigid. So one can ask, can we change this approach somehow, find a new proof that can be generalized to two different cases. So we want to generalize this. Not classification, okay, maybe classification, but basically generalize the boundness to high dimensional cases.
Can you remind what the boundness means?
Boundness belongs to finitely many families. Look, we have like P2, it's unique. When you blow up one point, it's unique. You blow up 2 points, it's unique. You blow up 3 points, it's unique. You blow up 4 points, it's still unique. You blow up 5 points, it has a moduli, one-dimensional family of modules, family. And since number of blow-ups is bounded, these guys contain infinitely many families. Explicit. So moduli is finite dimension. So high-dimensional case, and also singular case. And okay, so there are three approaches I know, and the fourth approach, which is completely new by Birka. So let me consider the old approaches to just, we just want to have another proof. So first of all, let me give you the simplest, in my opinion, simplest approach to boundness. First of all, there's a general principle, slogan. That the geometry of Fano varieties determined by small degree rational curves. Geometry of Fano varieties governed by small degree rational curves. Small degree with respect to anti-canonical, you know, rational curve.
They are doing one or two? Hmm? I'm not sure the single case. What are you discussing right now?
I'm discussing right now everything.
Case?
What? This is a goal, generalize this.
Each goal you are making that way.
No, we want to find new proofs which has a chance to be generalized to one of these cases. just different proof of the same result, maybe weaker result. We don't need classification, we just need the boundedness. But maybe it will help to prove the same result in more general situation. So geometry of finite variety is governed by small degree rational curves. So by rational curve, it means it's P1. Or maybe C is birational to P1. If it's singular, if curve is singular. And this is means this is small. I don't know. Small. This is degree. Okay, so if you look at this smooth surfaces here, the smallest possible degree is 1. So suppose C is P1, this is the smallest possible degree, but this is exactly minus 1 curves. There are finitely many of them, and we know that, for example, on cubic surface we have 27 lines, this is exactly minus 1 curves.
Now you're
thinking
about finite varieties?
No. I want to find a new proof in this case. This case, the same old case as yesterday. I just want to find a new proof, which can be, with some extra efforts, generalized to high dimensional case. Moreover, I can use this classification to cook up the proof. So I already know the answer.
I'm trying to understand the slogan.
So the slogan in general. Slogan in general. We have finite varieties. Small degree rational curves give you a lot of information about funnels. A lot. It's just a slogan, it's not very precise. So, if you have curves like this, usually you sometimes call them lines, and they are lines, and if anticanonical linear system give you embedding, but they're finitely many. Number, it's okay. Then, the next case is conic. And there's infinitely many, but there's finitely many conics going through general point. Finitely many conics passing through general point. Through a point. And the next case, cubics. There's a lot of them. So basically, two general points can be connected by this curve. Can be connected by such curve. And this curve, it's actually easily seen here. We consider this P2 case. We take a line in P2. And you take this general line here, and you take its transform here, and its anticanonical degree is 3. Because anticanonical divisor of this surface, it's a lift of pullback of anticanonical divisor of this guy, which is 3 lines minus exceptional curve. So if you take a generic line that doesn't pass through points of blow up, you get exactly. And vice versa, if you have such curve, it's basically gives you the.
And it's again a finite number of such?
No. There again. So two general points can be connected by such curves.
But it's not.
It's unique basically. Okay. You don't need this.
But this is great.
Okay. This immediately gives you boundedness in 1 second. So first of all, put it this way. I know this from classification. But I can actually prove, it's possible to prove this without using classification. Just using deformation theory of curves. And Mori results are called bend and break, existence of rational curves of finite varieties. You start deform them using some hard technique. But this is possible to prove without classification. With classification, this is obvious. Yeah, I take two general points here, I map them here, and in a plane, there's a unique line passing through 2 points, and then I pull back this line, that's it. But it's possible to do, actually similar results possible to do in higher dimensions, but degree of the curve is going to be higher. Okay, let's show how use this to immediately derive the boundedness. What is boundedness? Boundedness in this case, it's enough to bound this number. If you bound this number, basically through general results, so Matsusaka, Weak theorem, and with some approach generalization of color, it's